And the night has come, and the land is dark, and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid, just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me. Stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, or the mountain should crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by.
Now, what I'm going to do before we go any further is take those gorgeous flowers and just put them on the table. We've got something very special.
Yeah.
This lady has a beautiful piece. You feeling okay?
Yeah.
Now, and we didn't just meet outside, so you are allowed to hold hands and look after each other today.
Yeah.
I'd like to welcome you both here to Gretna Hall. This is a wonderful historic place to get married, and you're in the original Inn Coach House. You're about to become part of that lovely ongoing history that we have here in Gretna Green. And it's a delight to have you, Dean, and you, Karen, here to share your marriage with all of us here. You've chosen to come to Scotland, and it's wonderful to have you both here on Christmas Eve. So Fáilte go Alba, welcome to Scotland. And Fáilte go Gretna Green, welcome to Gretna Green. My name is Maura Warwick. I'm an assistant registrar appointed by the Registrar General for Scotland as a person authorised to solemnise civil marriages. And this is in accordance with the provision of Marriage Scotland Act 1977. But before I proceed with your marriage, it is necessary that you both identify yourselves to me. Are you Dean Robert Cattle?
I am.
Thank you. Are you Karen Angela Byrne?
I am.
That's wonderful. It's always a good start, isn't it? We'll now gather to hear that I may solemnise your marriage. And this is in the presence of your two witnesses, Isabel and Lynn. And in accordance with the law of Scotland, I can confirm that preliminary to your marriage, all has been satisfied. But before you, Dean, and you, Karen, are joined in marriage, it is my duty to remind you of the binding character of the vows that you're about to make. Marriage, according to the law of this country, is a union of two people voluntarily entered into for life. Are you both now ready to take that step forward in your journey?
Yes.
I now require that you make a declaration accepting each other as husband and wife. So if I could ask you to hold each other's right hands and face each other. That's right hand to right. And please, in turn, repeat the following after me. Dean, you'll go first. I, Dean Robert Cattell.
I, Dean Robert Cattell.
Solemnly and sincerely declare.
Solemnly and sincerely declare.
That I know of no legal impediment.
That I know of no legal impediment.
To my marrying Karen Angela
Burnett. To my marrying Karen Angela Burnett.
Karen Richard. I, Karen Angela Byrne.
I, Karen Angela Byrne.
Solemnly and sincerely declare.
Solemnly and sincerely declare.
That I know of no legal impediment.
That I know of no legal impediment.
To my marrying Dean Robert Cattell.
To my marrying Dean Robert Cattell.
Thank you. Now if I could ask you to face each other and hold all hands together. And this is the point where you make your solemn marriage vows. These vows are sincerely made and are for life. And again, I'm going to ask you to please go first.
Sure.
I deem accept you, Karen.
I deem accept you, Karen.
As my lawful wedded wife.
As my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
To the exclusion of all others.
To the exclusion of all others.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we shall both shall live.
Thank you. Karen, it's your turn. I, Karen, accept you, Dean.
I, Karen, accept you, Dean.
As my lawful wedded husband.
As my lawful wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
To the exclusion of all others.
To the exclusion of all others.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
And if you'd like to turn around and face the front line. You've both made your solemn marriage vows. And these are sealed with the giving and receiving of rings. Rings being the outward sign of those vows that you have just made and of the eternal love that you have for each other. If I could ask you, Dean, please, to pick up Karen's ring. And please place it on her finger. Ask you to please do the same for Dean.
Yeah.
And standing close together and holding each other's hands. Dean and Karen, through your declarations made to me and through your vows in front of your witnesses, Lynn and Isabel, it is my absolute delight to say you are both now husband and wife.
Thank
congratulations
you.
To you both.
Thank you.
You can have a kiss.
Thank you.
Yeah.